हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ अनवित गडकर। आई एम फ्रॉम IIT हैदराबाद इंडिया एंड आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माय वर्क ऑन रियोलॉजिकल बिहेवियर ऑफ अल्कली एक्टिवेटेड फ्लाई ऐश विद नैनोक्ले एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन। इट्स अ वेल नोन फैक्ट दैट सीमेंट इज़ वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट मैन्युफैक्चर्ड प्रोडक्ट एंड विद इंक्रीज इन डिमांड द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सीमेंट हैज़ ऑल्सो इंक्रीज्ड एंड वाइल प्रोड्यूसिंग द सीमेंट द एनर्जी कंज्यूम्ड एंड द कार्बन इमिशन आर वेरी हाई। दस वी नीड टू लुक फॉर अ मटेरियल विच इज़ मच मोर सस्टेनेबल इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द कार्बन फुटप्रिंट। Fly ash is one of the low energy material because it is an industrial byproduct from coal fired electricity generation and can be used as an alternate to cement. Its production in India is very high, whereas its utilization is comparatively less and its disposal is difficult. So basically fly ash mixed with alkaline activator and cured at elevated temperature gives us a product which has binding properties and hence can be used as a replacement to cement in construction industry. Understanding the rheological properties of alkali activated fly ash paste helps us to increase its potential usage. In this regard, we have identified three controllables for the paste system to control its rheological properties. Those are silica modulus, silica content, and solution to binder. The paste once prepared is subjected to the following protocols in order to understand the rheological properties, but in this study we are just going to focus on the constant strain rate test. And here we have used a strain controlled rheometer with cup and vane geometry to understand the rheological properties of the paste. What we found is the paste on subjecting to constant strain rate gives us two distinct type of behaviors, that is classical yield type response and Maxwell type of response. A classical yield type of response is one where the paste on subjecting to a constant strain reaches a peak value, there is a subsequent breakdown, and then it carries a comparatively lower load. But in case of Maxwell type of response, there is the paste on straining reaches to a peak stress value, but there is no breakdown that is observed, and on the continuous straining, the material keeps on stretching and carries the same amount of load. So in case of high solutes loading of solution to binder 0.3, the paste exhibited the yield type of response, but whereas in case of low solutes loading of solution to binder 0.33 and also in case of 0.35 and 0.4, we observed only Maxwell type of response. The yield type of response was observed because of the solid to solid contact between the particles, whereas in the Maxwell type of response was observed because of the continuous reorientation of the internal structure and a liquid dominated response. But we found an interesting result in case of intermediate solids loading, where both Maxwell type as well as the yield type of response was present. And for the entire range that was studied, we could establish a transition line or a dividing line separating the two types of behavior. That is, Maxwell type of response was observed with the paste with the lower silica modulus, whereas the yield type of response was observed with paste with higher silica modulus for the same solution to binder. But after addition of nanoclay to the paste which exhibited Maxwell type of response, we saw there was a transition in the type of rheological response and it exhibited yield type of response. That is, for all the alkali activated fly ash paste in case of intermediate solids loading which exhibited Maxwell type of response, after adding the nanoclay, we observed the change in the behavior as shown here. And thus there was in the entire range that was studied, there were no paste now after adding the nanoclay which exhibited Maxwell type of behavior. Even in case of solid loading of 0.33 and 0.35 and 0.4, after adding nanoclay, this transition in the type of rheological response was observed. But why do we need to study this? The point is, when trying to create a cellular structure within the alkali activated fly ash paste, the paste exhibiting only the yield type of response gave us a stable bubble structure, whereas in case of Maxwell type of response, there was no bubble structure within the matrix and all the bubbles collapsed. But after adding the nanoclay and after observing the change in response from Maxwell to yield type, and for the same paste, after adding the aluminium powder, we observed a bubble structure within the system. So the conclusion from this entire exercise is that yield stress is necessary for a stable bubble structure to be created in the alkali activated fly ash system. Thank you.